Hi, I'm Val from the Utah Education Network. Have you ever used Google Slides as a graphic organizer or template that you want students to fill out? In this video, I will show you how to use the Google Assignments LTI to assign students a Google Slide template that they will make a copy of, fill out, and submit to Canvas. We are going to turn this Google Slide deck into an assignment in Canvas. Students will receive their own copy of that template and fill it out themselves. First, make sure that you have the original slide deck created. This will be the template that all the students will make a copy of. You can see I have created a slide deck called Third Grade Animal Reports, and I'm going to have my students fill out these slides. Next, we'll come over to Canvas and we will add an assignment. If you want to use a grading rubric to help you score the student-submitted slides, you will want to generate that and get it in place before you establish the rest of the settings. So I'm going to click on the rubric button. I have one already prepared that I'm just going to pull up and apply to this assignment. Okay, now that my rubric is in place, I can fill in the rest of the settings. I'm going to click on Edit. You'll want to type in some instructions here. For your students, you'll probably want to let them know that this is a Google slide deck they're going to be making a copy of, and then they're going to be filling it out on their end. And when it's time to submit, they'll come back to Canvas and submit that. Make sure that you fill in points that match the rubric that you created and any of these other settings as you see fit. Then come down here to submission type, use the pull down menu and select external tool. We need to click on find and scroll down until we see Google Assignments LTI 1.3. When I click on that, it will verify my Google account that I'm using with Canvas. And the first thing we're going to do to create this Google assignment is to attach that slide deck that we already created, the third grade animal report. I found it, clicked on it, and I'm going to hit add. Now, when it comes to grading, you have two options down here. If you use Google Assignments often, you may want to select Google Assignments and then you will grade everything in Google Assignments. For me, that adds an extra step. I don't want to do my grading in Google Assignments. I prefer to do my grading in SpeedGrader, right in Canvas. So I'm going to click on Canvas SpeedGrader, and this will allow the students to turn in their slide deck and it will convert it as a view only file for me. And then I will use SpeedGrader. I will use the rubric that I already created and I will put all of my comments in my rubric and right there in SpeedGrader for the students. So click create. And now you can hit select. And you can see that external tool URL is now here. And you can scroll down and complete any of the other settings that are important for you and your students. When you are ready, you can click Save and Publish. You now have created the assignment. If you want to remind yourself what the slide deck template looked like that you originally assigned your students, you can click here on the paperclip. And then click and you can view the template. If we come back to the Canvas course, when students start turning in their slide decks, you will see them start to populate right here. Now we see a student submission here. We can click on SpeedGrader in the top right corner to view and grade the student slides. And we have the rubric button here that we can click on and fill out the rubric. And scroll through. click on the rubric and do our grading. You can leave comments here. Remember that you have the capability of leaving typed comments, audio comments, or video comments. And if for some reason you want to comment directly on the student's slides, come back to the submission page of the assignment. And you can get directly to their live slides by clicking on that paperclip. And you can comment here. This is what the student will see on their end when they navigate to this assignment. Canvas has already made a copy of the slides and put their name on it, as you can see right here. They can click here to open the slides and work on them. When they are ready to submit, they will come back to the submission page and hit open to attach and submit. You can see that their slide deck is already here and all they have to do is hit submit. And then hit submit one more time. I hope this video has given you an idea of how you can use Canvas to provide your students with a slide template that they fill out. Thanks for joining me today on Canvas Corner.